In our last video, we created our very own AI assistant using Microsoft 365 Copilot. It was fast, easy, and a great way to answer questions internally. But what if you could turn it from a simple helper into a powerful automator for your business? What if you could not only answer questions, but perform tasks for you? Well, that's exactly what we're going to do today. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teacher's Tech. Today, we're taking our agent to the next level. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the full power of Microsoft Copilot Studio to teach your bot how to automate tasks, like sending an email or even responding to emails. In the previous video, I showed you how to use Microsoft 365 Copilot to create PoochPal, a customer service agent. We're going to recreate this now inside Copilot Studio. So this is copilotstudio.microsoft.com. I'll put the link down below in the description. And remember, to log in, you do need a work or school account. Your personal Microsoft accounts won't work for this. We're going to quickly go through setting up our agent again. So if you didn't watch that video, you can start here. And I'm just going to move over to create. And then we're going to go to new agent, and we're going to create our PoochPal here. Now, let's tell Copilot what we want. I'm just going to put this in, create an agent that answers customer questions about dog grooming business, Pooch Haven Spa. It should be friendly and helpful. Let's call it PoochPal. I'm going to send this off, and you'll see how quickly, again, it starts with creating my agent. And now it's set up. You can see it's called PoochPal. So just like before, I'm going to go to configure here, and I want to change a couple things, because the one thing right away, I don't want my agent, the icon to be looking like this. So I'm going to hit edit, and I'm going to upload an icon. I have one ready here. So I'm just going to go to my desktop to PoochPal. And I believe I had a JPEG. That's why it didn't show up the first time. So I'm going to grab this. And here it is right here. So I'm going to put apply, and I have my icon. This is the name, so I could change it if I change it here as well. I didn't have to name it inside the when I prompt it, but it would adapt over here. The description is going to be what shows up here, so I could add more at any time. Maybe I want to put an email address in here, and then that's going to show up over here to my agent. Here are the instructions right now. So right now it created these ones. So respond to customer inquiries about Pooch Haven Spa with accurate, friendly, and helpful information. All these points are here is what the AI put just based on my description that I wanted. I can add more to this. I could just move down to the bottom, hit enter, and let's paste this in here. Never discuss topics unrelated to PoochPal Haven Spa. So I said, if you don't know the answer to a question, provide documents, don't make one up. And I just said to give the email here. So if it doesn't know the answer, it's going to respond by giving the email. So you can add these things or take away anything to make it do what you want. Now this here, and what you're going to notice with the Copilot Studio here is you're going to have more options to create a smarter agent over here. I'm going to quickly add some knowledge just like I did before, but I'm going to show you some other options as well. So if we hit add, the first thing I want to add is going to be my link. And I'm just going to go quickly to my Pooch Haven Spa website and go back. I'm going to go to public website and enter a link, and I'll hit add, and we'll add to agent. So it will be able to take this information from the website. If I update something on the website, this agent will automatically have the newer information as well. And with this other information, I'm going to have to create my agent first before I can add more. Right now, I could still connect to a SharePoint site, but I'm going to come back and just show you some of the other items. I'll add some documents. I'll hit cancel. And if we keep going down below, I just want to show you, you can enable web search. So this will be able to search all public websites to try to find the information. I don't want this on because I just want it to be able to look at my website and the documents that I'm going to give. Down below here, these are the suggested prompts here. So you'll notice over here, all of these will match up. So ask about services. This is the message. I can go ahead and delete any of these. I can, this is move. So if I want to move it up, you're going to see how it changes over here, or I can even add some more suggestions. I could start using it right now. I'll come back to after when I create this, but it's good to have these suggested prompts on because sometimes people don't know what they even want to ask. ask, and this will give them some ideas what they can. So we have all this set up. Let's go ahead and just create now. Now you can see that our agent is provisioned. We haven't published it. You can see there's publish up here. I'm not going to do that until we finish setting different things up. We do have a test mode, and I will come back to that in a moment. I want to go to knowledge because I want to add a few more things. So I'm going to click add knowledge, and you'll see this time it looks a little different. I could connect to OneDrive or SharePoint, or I can select and browse. So if I go back to my desktop and I have a few documents, I'm going to grab these two Microsoft Word documents, and I'm going to go and add them to the agents. You can see that it's a frequently asked questions and something about the services and pricing. So I'm going to add this to agent. Now we have our three sources for knowledge. If anything changes in these documents, you will need to re-upload them. So notice if I click on here, I can click delete, and then you can re-upload the newer ones. The website, you don't have to worry about this because it will just go get the newer information as you update the website. I'm going to click on knowledge one more time because I want to point out some of the other connections you can make. Notice that we have things like Dataverse, or if we go to over here to the advanced, you could connect to an Oracle database. So you could actually connect this to sales information where it could go and make those connections and pull that information, and your agent can converse with it. But I'm not going to add any of those for this beginner's tutorial. Let's give our agent a quick test over here. I'm just going to ask it, what are our hours? And the information should be being pulled from here. I'm going to send this off. And here we have our answer. Poochhaven Spa operates from Monday to Saturday, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. And it went ahead and put that information from the knowledge, that one question that I put in for the instructions at the end. So it grabbed that. That's just a fake email there. So seem things to be working correctly currently. I want Pooch Pal to do more than just answer questions. And that's where tools come in. And I'm going to add one here. I want to point out we can add tool here. If I go up to the top here, we have knowledge, tools, and you're going to see even more options to other things. But this will get you to, if I add a tool here, or if I go back and add a tool here, both of them will be the same place. So let's go ahead and click on add tool. There's thousands of tools you can add. So if I click all here and I'll just do a quick scroll down, you can see if you're looking for something, it's probably going to be there. So I'm going to keep this pretty easy on this one here today. I'm just going to go back to featured because I want my Pooch Pal to be able to send an email of the conversation that they're having or the answer to the person's email. And I want the agent to take care of that. So with this tool, I'm going to go click on this one, Office 365 Outlook. You can see all the different options that you can do with Microsoft Outlook here. What I want to do is this one right here, send an email V2. So when Pooch Pal is discussing something with somebody, I want them to have the option. The person can get an email sent to them if they answer that's what they want. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this. Let's go to add and configure. All right, let's make a few changes here. This first part, the details, this is how it gets identified. And I'm just going to make this a little bit shorter here. I'm just going to say send an email. This is the description. I'm going to go and say this operation sends an email response to customer, let's say to a customer. And we'll keep moving down. Here's our tool, our connections, our agent. You can see there's more details here. I'm going to leave these just the same. I just want to point out to if you want to go through these and add some more details. Now down here, I'm not going to be changing any of these because I like them when they're saying dynamically fill with AI, because what the AI will be able to do is pull the information from the conversation the agent is having and know how to fill this in. You can customize the value at any time. So if I had it on customize value, and then I can go add that in. So for any of these, you can do that custom value. If you're in the body, if you wanted to type something specifically to show up each time, you could go ahead and do that. I like just using the dynamically fill with AI. It gets good responses, good fill-in for those three different items there. Nothing else to change here. I'm going to go ahead and click save. So now that this is all saved, we have to tell Pooch Pal now when to use this. And we need to go back to the overview and we're going to need to go to edit because we need to add this to the instructions. So let's click edit in the instructions. I'm going to give it another line and I'm going to put this in. When you answer the user's question, offer to email the response. If they accept, use send an email. Remember, this is what we called that tool. So send an email tool with a summary of that interaction. So it knows this is the tool that it's going to use. Let's go back up again, hit save, and save one more time here. Let's give it a test. We'll use the same question we asked before. We'll say, what are your hours? So it should change this time with the email option there. And here we go. Would you like me to email this to you? And if I say yes, and I can hear I just got an email. Let's jump over to my Outlook here, right here. Hello, Jamie. Thank you for your inquiry about the Pooch Haven Spa hours. We can see the information is here and it was emailed to me. Now, if we take a look over on the left, we have an activity map, and this showed me step by step what happened with the agent. So at first, it went and found the information. So I can see where it found the information of the time in this document here. And then after I said yes over here that I wanted to email, then it went and performed with this tool, the send an email tool. And this was the email that was sent out. So you can kind of see step by step how everything is working. Now I want my agent to be proactive and work on its own, even with no one chatting with it. And this is where I need to add a trigger. I'm back under the overview now, and I'm going to scroll down under tools. And you can see we have triggers right here. I'm just going to click on add trigger. Now think of a trigger as an alarm clock for your bot. Instead of waiting for a person to ask a question, the bot gets to work when a specific event happens. For example, you can set up a trigger for when a new email arrives in a specific inbox. The bot could automatically read it, find the key information, and maybe create a support ticket. When someone submits a Microsoft form, the bot could take the response and add them to an Excel sheet or a database. When a new item is added in SharePoint, the bot could notify the relevant team members in Microsoft Teams. Essentially, triggers turn your chatbot from reactive helper into an autonomous member of your team that can kick off workflows by itself. Let's do this one right here, when a new email arrives, because I could see this being something with a customer service aspect to it. I'm going to click on it. We'll go next. You can give your trigger a name. I'm just going to leave it as default. You need to make sure that you're signed into the services that you're using, and those are all signed in. I'm going to click next. Now, these are different filters that you can add to what you want the trigger to happen. You can pick from, if you look at some of these, you can mail folders to check for new emails. So you can make it specific to your Outlook, to what folder it's coming into. Is it to or from or attachments? You can see these are all items that you can filter things specifically. I'm just going to keep this all the same right now, because any email that comes in, I'm just going to get it to respond to those. So I'm just going to go ahead and click create trigger. Okay, time to test the trigger. We'll close out of here. We do need to make a change to the instructions now, because this right here, we don't want it to ask the customer. This is going to go into our email and respond to those. So let's go ahead and hit edit. So we don't want this one right here. We'll delete it, but I do need to give it a new instruction. And this is what I'm going to say. Send an email using the send an email tool that we created to reply to the sender from when a new email arrives V3 trigger that we created. Remember, those are the names that we gave them, and those are in quotation marks. Trigger with a detailed professional manner. So it's supposed to reply to them with an email answering their questions. Let's go ahead and save this. And now we can go down to triggers and let's test this out. Now we need to trigger the event. I have an email that I'm about to send here. Let's go ahead and send it. Here's the email that I received, that I sent. So this should be the trigger. And here I am back in my other account, which is a Gmail account. And you can see I got a detailed response telling me about the spa package, the price and everything in it. And everything was automatic there. The one thing I don't like about this response, this isn't edited very well. We can make a change in the instructions. So let me pop back over to my instructions here, and I'm going to show you what I changed. So let's go up here and right here. So I went back and made a little bit of an edit, and I'm going to resend the email and I'll show you what it looks like now. So I said, format the email in HTML. And this was the same as before, and respond in a detailed, professional manner. So just by telling it to format the email in HTML, I'm going to bring the new email back over that I already ran. And here it is right here. So you can see, hello, Jamie. We have the spaces, we have bolded, and all I did was tell it to use the HTML format. So something you might want to think about when giving those responses in those emails. I want to move over to activity over here and point out a few different things. So this shows me how the agent's been working. It's a great place to go to check on things, but I want to show you a few things that's happened and some changes I made where I was checking on things. So if I go to this one right here, we'll begin with this. So I can see that it received the query right here, and I can see how it responded to it. It found it in the information from that Word document, and then it went and sent an email. So this was, it worked, it sent the email out, but remember the formatting wasn't really there the way I wanted. If I go back and I check these more recent ones here, you'll notice that there's a third one here. So it kind of did the same thing here. We have our query about the spa, then it had the responses to it, and we know all that information. We had this send email, but then remember how I changed it? I said format in HTML. If I take a look at this one now, this is all formatted in HTML here. This is how we got the better looking email in it. And if I go back to activity again, and I'll go back to here, this is one time I was running it and I forgot to change my instructions to tell it to use the tool and the trigger that I've added to it after. And you can see it got the query, but then it never did anything. So the activity gives you a great place to check on how your agents are performing. And that's a lot of how I problem solve too, to see what's happening and what I might have to change to the instructions or add tools or triggers to it. So do take a look at activity. Now, the one thing we haven't done is published our agent yet. We've gone through and we've been testing it. But if I go ahead, just click up top now, it's a very quick thing to publish. We just need to review these and everything's okay. We'll hit publish. So now it's live. Any new emails coming in will automatically get that trigger and the responses will happen. But we can also share this agent out. If we go up to channels, and then you can see all the different places that you can share your agent to. A demo website, Teams or Microsoft 365 Copilot, SharePoint, a web app, native app, Facebook. So you just need to choose the one you want and go through and set up the connections for those. But if you see the diamond, you're going to notice that there's a premium. I don't have premium on this account. So if you want to, you can go ahead and go premium and get set up with that. Another thing you might want to check out is the analytics, and this will be showing you how your agent is working over time and to see the effectiveness. If there's any maybe questions or different things that aren't getting responded to, you can check these and maybe you can update the knowledge base to help with those. If I go back over to home now, you'll see we have Pooch Pal here. This is an agent that we've created, so it will be here. So if I just click on it again, it will open it up. It's saved within here. And there you have it. We've taken our simple AI agent and transformed it into a task automating assistant using the power of Microsoft Copilot Studio. There's so much more to explore, and I'll definitely be creating more videos to dive deeper into these advanced topics. So if you want to continue on this journey, make sure that you're subscribed to Teachers Tech so you don't miss what's coming next. Thanks for watching this week. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.